Hi everyone, this video is to show how to do confidence intervals for one sample models in both Minitab and Minitab Express. So we'll start with Minitab. We can make a confidence interval for the mean, a confidence interval for the standard deviation or variance, and a confidence interval for proportion. So I'll go over all three of those. So let's say I wanted to make a confidence interval for the mean easiness rating. Let's say I want to make a 95% confidence interval. Well, I could just go into stat, basic statistics, and just go to one sample t. And then say, okay, I want to do the easiness rating and set the confidence level right here. So it's set for 95% right now. So you just click okay. And it creates the confidence interval for you right here. So the confidence interval is gives you the two right, left and right endpoints. And if you want to find the margin of error, you would subtract one of the endpoints, like the right endpoint, from the sample mean, which is shown also on this list. Okay, so that's how you make a confidence interval for the mean. If you wanted to make a confidence interval for variance, you would go under stat, basic statistics, one variance. And this is also a confidence interval for the standard deviation. So again, we're going to select easiness. It's going to look very similar. This time, let's make a 99% confidence interval just to do something different. So I just changed the confidence level to 99%. And there we have a 99% confidence interval. Now, if the data has a normal distribution, we use that chi-squared distribution that we covered in class. So we're going to assume for the purposes of this lab that all the data sets will follow a normal distribution, and you can use the chi-square confidence interval formula. Okay, the third type of confidence interval for one sample is a one sample test of proportion when you have a yes, no, or a binary question. So under stat, basic statistics, we go to one proportion. And so let's say I want to find a 95% confidence interval for percentage of students at a particular college. So I'm going to pick college. And again, you can set the confidence level to 95 or 99% here. And then just click OK, and this gave us confidence for Foothill. You can see that between 0.256 and 0.325, or between 25.5 and 32.5% of the ratings for Foothill College. The choices again were Foothill, De Anza. Okay, so that's how you find the confidence intervals in Minitab. For Minitab Express, All the confidence intervals are in a slightly different place. You just go under statistics on the top bar, and it's just one sample. And here's the confidence interval for the T. And you can see it's the same formula. Confidence interval for the variance, very similar here. Let's just do this one here. So let's say I wanted to do easiness rating, and I wanted to do a 99%. You just set the confidence level. And these are all pretty much run the same way as in Minitab. So you get the same answer. And then finally, let's do the one sample. We can do the proportion test right here. And again, we could say, okay, we're looking at, say, we're gonna do college, Foothill. You could change that to De Anza if you want. And then you just, again, you can set the confidence level there and get the confidence interval for the proportion. And that's it. That's how you run confidence intervals for one sample models in both Minitab and Minitab Express.